So they begin to teach, be hard upon yourself, sit into positions that are not comfortable for yourself. Don't try to live a life of ease, because that life of ease is again going to go into the soul and block everything. That's why when Ramadan comes and people say, oh, you know, I get a headache by 8 o'clock. But that's good, because you don't get a headache any other time. These times are difficult. And when we live a life with everything is resolved by Tylenol and Advil, we actually experience no difficulty anymore. That difficulty and that hardship makes us to realize we are alive, we are very much alive, and a little bit of struggling in Allah's way goes a long way in Divinely Presence. So that struggle is important for us, those difficulties and hardships are important for us, that destroys the hawa. The nafs and the understanding that the nafs is the big shariq with Allah, that everything of the turuqs is based on destroying the nafs. And that nafs, if you don't destroy it, that is the one that becomes shariq with Allah, not the soul. The soul never goes near that, and there's no way to be a partner with Allah. But the nafs, it wants to be a partner, it becomes the partner with shaitan to plan against Ar-Rahman, means everything it does will come against Allah and come against what Allah wants. Means that's when you take your path serious and every thought that coming to you begin to think, why do I want to fast? It's not for your soul, it's because your nafs wants to be in charge of your body. If you give enough for your nafs, it's going to come against Allah. Why don't want to give? Why don't want to pray? Why don't want to participate? It's not the soul, it's not the soul. The soul wants to be crushed. The soul wants that destroy everything so that we'll be free with Allah. So anything that's complaining and any voice that coming to you by complaint is the nafs. And if you become aware and conscious that, why am I complaining now? That is my nafs. I can only find fault in everybody but I find no fault in myself. Oh, this is a big zalim. This is like a Pharaoh, that you can, mashallah, your eyes so strong that you can see problems of everybody but you can't see any problems in your own. This is the worst of character. My kids can have that character. That's not a rijal, that's not somebody who's developed in Allah's way. The one who developed in Allah's way inherits from Prophet. The Prophet said, if you find your brother, find 70 excuses for him. Don't say something bad about your brother.